Well, we hope you're enjoying the air show so far. We have plenty more warbird action to come.
With other airshow teams. We went to the convention in December and Las Vegas and found out we would be coming to Oshkosh in the spring. Here they are, our solo. Today marks Trojan Thunder's debut at Oshkosh. Skydock demonstrates some of his aerobatic capability. You see Jive coming around in a 360. All of our team members reside from areas across the United States. They come together to rehearse and do shows just like they're showing right now, and incoming from the left for what we call our dirty diamond. That means the gear is down and the air is dirty around those aircraft, and they're going slow with those big, beautiful radial engines.
The aircraft from the 1950s to the 1980s.
If you look look closely, you will see that some of the aircraft being flown by our Trojan Thunder pilots also have tail hooks still attached. Photos and videos. And this is to say thank you to everyone at EAA AirVenture, both staff and volunteers, who make this week possible for all of us to enjoy. Thank you from Trojan Thunder.
Size, and we're told by the C-47 or the Dakota into a cleared area in the enemy's area. Now, it was a little bit more efficient than dropping parachutes because your group of 13 all landed together, adjacent your powerless glider after it landed and skidded to a stop would be one outfitted with a jeep or some artillery. With surgical precision, the trained troops would unload the gliders, put the artillery behind the jeep, and head for the protection of a wood. They would leave that glider behind because that material could not do the enemy any harm. We have two young people here who are with us, and I'd like to introduce them to you now. They are Stephanie Hatch and Mark Stanfield. And the Piper, the aircraft that we're going to fly today, the Piper GTA, an independent glider, and a zero-craft